resto shaman. Now, this is the group therapy comp that we saw from Europe back in last week. So this is also a very, very strong in the meta. Let's see how they do.
Let's see what Sheepy Boy can do for this Storm. This is a composition that we loved when we saw it the first time around, but they're going up against one of the top dogs of North America, the Frogs.
Yeah, Sheepy Boy, also known as Ozai in this matchup, primarily plays Mage, but actually picked up the Shadow Priest, and I think that's really good for Storm. Gives him some more well-rounded compositions. Metaphor's actually on his Restoration Shaman. It's a nice setup for Storm. Super Frogs, how are they going to handle this? So far, good pressure onto Sheepy Boy. Interrupt on Maldiva, and I think it's likely Super Frogs are just going to try to take control of this game, really limit the amount of damage Maldiva is able to do with large crowd control change on Metaphor, force out cooldowns from Sheepy Boy, and I kind of feel like Storm's going to struggle to find pressure, and at least a little bit later on in the game.
Beautiful setup here by Wealthy Man, getting an extended crowd control chain and pulling two defensive cooldowns from the team of Storm in one singular push. But now Wealthy Man is overextended. Maldiva looks to punish. Nope. Immediately, Wealthy Man going back to that corner, knowing exactly where to position against a Destruction Warlock. Snuts is now the overextended player of the team. Let's see how he deals with this. Counterspell from Wealthy Man is going to back up Snuts, denying some Chaos Bolts for now. Snuts is ramping up, looking to go for a Vendetta play here shortly. Wealthy Man blinking into center field, looking for some defensive polymorphs onto Maldiva. Gets shut down by a Fear. Now Cubsy instead jumping into the battle. Both Wealthy Man and Cubsy chasing down Metaphors for crowd control. They get denied. Good denial from Maldiva in this critical moment. Otherwise, Void Shift may be a likely trade, but due to Maldiva's defense, they get to keep that cooldown for a later date.
Yeah, Sheepy Boy still trying to find some damage. Full Sheep secured on the Metaphor. Sheepy Boy could be in a lot of trouble. Might have to trade out the Void Shift. Just waiting, sitting by the gateway. I'm not sure if he actually has it available at this time, but that's definitely a solid defense for him to use the gateway, get out of trouble if he really needs to. Snuts committing the Kidney Shot on Metaphors, extending the crowd control chain. There's the Void Shift on the Metaphors before he goes into the Cyclone. But because he's diminishing returns on the stun, Metaphors, he's not going to be too afraid of actually getting swapped to in this situation. Sheepy Boy still low. Version has just a few seconds left. Earthen Shield Totem gets dropped out. Both members from Storm are low at this time. Maldiva trying to find some pressure for his team, manages to land a Fear on Cubsy, but there has just been no damage from Storm in this matchup.
No counter pressure whatsoever. Snuts now sees an opening, goes after Metaphors in a swap, trying to take him down. Pre-Ghost Wolf appears to be enough for Metaphors to survive through the Stunlock with the Astral Shift. Good defense on his part to stay in the fight. Now blinded. Is he going to make the trade? Yes, he is. Gladiator's Medallion is now out of the way, and that's an opening for the Super Frogs to leap all over. Will they take it moving forward is the question. Maldiva finally getting some counter pressure here. Chaos Bolts gets denied. Good defense by Wealthy Man. Now securing Polymorphs. Sheepy Boy in a 3-on-1 trades out Dispersion to stay alive throughout this attack, but even still, the crowd control is endless. There is no more defense if they can't access Metaphor. Now he's out of crowd control and has that Spiritling Totem if necessary. It looks like Fade should be enough. Now a Cyclone at low health, making it awkward for the team of Storm to stabilize and maybe creating an opening for Wealthy Man to move forward. I definitely think the Super Frogs have been in a commanding position as Storm look to find their footing.
Yeah, interrupt on Maldiva, kick on Sheepy Boy, Kidney Shot on Sheepy Boy, Full Sheep on Metaphors. Super Frogs just has complete control of this game. Sheepy Boy all alone in this matchup. Metaphors does have the Spirit Link. They need to buy him enough time to actually get it off. Drops out the Earthen Shield Totem. Is it going to be enough to keep him alive with the Vampiric Embrace? I think it's going to be, and Gladiator Safeguard. That's enough defense for Sheepy Boy to stay alive. Now, it looks like Metaphors will be able to hold on to that precious Spirit Link Totem. Interrupt now onto Cubsy, as once again, Maldiva's trying to find some pressure, but there's just been so much control from Super Frogs. Just been really struggling. Cubsy at some point might actually have to try to sneak away for his drink. For a drink, all these defensive Cyclones are costing his mana quite a bit. Kidney Shot Smoke Bomb on Sheepy Boy. Are they gonna be able to take him down? Full Sheep once again secured onto Metaphor. Sheepy Boy might have to go for a Master Spell play here, but opting not to just yet. Wanting to fake out the counter spell. Just not enough damage for Super Frogs to close it out.
Yep, just not enough damage left to finish the match. However, Wealthy Man does have Icy Veins available, so they will retreat back, look for a reset, then make a big push. Maybe a potential swap to Metaphors, try and force him to use the Gladiator's Medallion in a blind play. Doesn't appear to be the case. Instead, just going for an attack onto the Shadow Priest, trying to burst him down, maybe a Blink counterspell. Wealthy Man has been lining up Polymorphs from across the map with double Blink in to secure crowd control. He's definitely been a playmaker in game number one against a composition that is typically challenging as a mage to actually secure crowd control against. He's been able to find tons of opportunities. blinking in once again, getting a full polymorph, counterspelling the Shadow Priest, denying dispersion for a few seconds. Thankfully, the Shadow Priest is running that dwarf racial, I do believe, so was able to remove a lot of that damage over time effects, but still ultimately has to trade dispersion, putting Storm further behind.
Yeah, Kitty Shot and Sheepy Boy, it's not over yet. Metaphor still trying to top him off, gets caught into a DR polymorph, into a full cyclone by Cubsy. Beautiful control from Super Frog. Polymorph on Maldiva. 3-on-1 situation. Spirit Link Totem gets dropped out there by Metaphors. The last line of defense to keep Sheepy Boy alive. And now Maldiva, he's going to have to do work in order to keep his teammates up. Fear on Cubsy, looking for some counter pressure on Wealthy Man. He denies with the Temporal Shield. Snuts has Cloak of Shadows as well. Not too many openings here for Storm. Sheepy Boy trying to survive. Beautiful Ring of Frost coming in from Super Frogs. Sheepy Boy once again in a 3-on-1 situation. Follow-up Polymorph. Silence coming in from Sheepy Boy, denying. Metaphors finally get some heals. Earthen Shield Totem will keep him alive in this situation with the Vampiric Embrace, but the next setup from Super Frogs is going to be devastating for Storm.
Wealthy Man's performance in this match is unparalleled. This composition is typically a nightmare for a mage, and he's navigating through it excellently, finding openings at every opportunity to put his team in the driver's seat to close up the match. Nice life grip into the Frozen Orb by the Shadow Priest, breaking that polymorph. Really good coordination, but they follow it up instantly as that Frozen Orb fades with more polymorphs. Sheepy doing whatever he can with mind control. Maldiva backing him up with fears, buying enough time for Metaphors to get out of crowd control and start to stabilize. Clutch play by Sheepy Boy. Without that life grip, he would have been the end of the match for sure.
Yep, and Sheepy Boy, he has just a few seconds left on that dispersion, so he's going to be feeling relatively safe, but I feel like Super Frogs is just going to pull it out immediately. The second that comes off cooldown, they're forced to use it. Now with the full polymorph on Metaphor, Sheepy Boy could potentially still go down. Do they have the damage to take him down? Full Cyclone onto Maldiva, 3-on-1 situation. Once again, complete control from Super Frogs. Polymorph on Metaphors. Is there any follow-up? Sheepy Boy getting lower, trying to survive. Throws out a silence, fear onto Cubsy to try to slow down some of this crowd control. But Sheepy Boy, he's just struggled so much in this matchup to actually get any damage rolling. Storm's just hanging on by a thread.
And now the executed crowd control moves forward to close out the match. How will they respond? They've got cooldowns to trade. It would be an error not to, and they do. But now they can make a swap. Snuts is silencing up the whole team, setting up Wealthy Man potentially, denied by Metaphors. Infernal gets dropped. Maldiva looks to counter pressure. If Maldiva can get in some big Chaos Bolts here, just sneak off a couple, potentially they can walk away with game number one. Maldiva is ramping up. He's gotten through most of the interrupts. Chaos Bolt number one casted. Chaos Bolt number two connects. That Temporal Shield soaks up all the damage. Wealthy Man is just on point with both defense and offense, but now Maldiva switches his attention to Snuts. Chaos Bolt in the air. Cloak of Shadows by Snuts denies the kill. Now Sheepy Boy on the back foot, desperately trying to stay alive. Metaphors catches a couple of healing waves, managing to scrape his health back alive and into the fight. Good counter pressure on Maldiva's part to at least keep his team in the match, but still so far behind.
Yes, silence on the Wealthy Man, denying his polymorph. Was he able to fake cast the wind here? There's a full bash onto Metaphors. Wealthy Man sets up for a Ring of Frost, manages to find it. If he can sheep Maldiva here, that's complete control of the team. Sheepy Boy still getting low, looking for mind controls. He has a dispersion, so he can keep himself alive. Metaphors, Spirit Link Totem rotating back up. But my main fear for Storm at this point is Metaphors almost completely tapped on mana. The single target pressure coming in from Super Frogs has been overwhelming. Icy Veins gets traded out. Sheepy Boy still low, forced into dispersion, overlapped with the Gladiator Safeguard Trinket. A lot of the defense he has left is really not going to be available. Vendetta gets used by Snuts. Well, the man's Icy Veins has just faded. Kitty Shot onto Sheepy Boy. Will he be able to survive? Metaphors desperately trying to hold on with his Ascendance, throwing out some healing waves, but a full polymorph secured. Sheepy Boy gets interrupted. Once again, a 3-on-1 situation. Sheepy Boy, how are you going to survive this? Vampiric Embrace healing might be enough. Can Metaphors get off the Spear Link Totem? But a beautiful Kitty Shot by Snuts. And Super Frog with a hop, skip, and a leap jumps all over Storm.
And they're able to
spell available from Maldiva to shut down the fears, and it's just been really good execution.
All right, Super Frogs were able to take the first one. What does the Storm have in store?
We are about to find out what the forecast is here. Will they be able to avoid the crowd control necessary to execute some counter pressure? So far, not looking to be the case as Super Frogs take complete control, forcing a Glider's Medallion from Metaphors, one major objective off of their list of cooldowns to work through. Next one is going to be a dispersion from Sheepy Boy, and if Super Frogs setup after setup can execute these defensive cooldowns, they will eventually isolate their target with no defense to stay alive.
Yeah, bash on Metaphors, polymorph on Maldiva, Ring of Frost looking to get set up there by Wealthy Man, manages to find it. Sheepy Boy now into a Kitty Shot, big burst pressure. Dispersion does get traded out, but a lot of that dispersion healing is getting absorbed by the Gladiator's Maledict of Super Frogs. Sheepy Boy doesn't get topped off, still trying to run away, create distance, find some damage. Smoke Bomb with the Cyclone. I think that was a little bit of a miscommunication there by Super Frogs, but ultimately Sheepy Boy's HP will be paused, and that buys time for diminishing returns. Now Metaphors once again into a full stun. Sheepy Boy might have to trade out the Void Shift at this point in the game. Now Diva has to try to do something to keep his team back in this game.
Super Frogs have been getting exactly the execution that they need and is necessary to take down the composition that Storm have brought to the table here today. Super Frogs retreat back behind the pillar to avoid Maldiva's counter pressure, dancing around the Destruction Warlock perfectly. And now, once that threat is thwarted, Cubsy and Wealthy Man are going to look to get aggressive, trying to fake cast any incoming spell locks. They fake cast the Wind Shear. So Sheepy Boy instead stuns Wealthy Man to slow down incoming crowd control. Metaphors is pinned at the pillar. Cubsy has him stuck against the wall. He tries to move in line of sight so his team can break up the crowd control, but no one was able to break it up. Now he's caught into a polymorph. Sheepy Boy is isolated with not much left to his name in terms of cooldowns, getting interrupted by Snuts, denying that Void Shift. Will he be able to trade it off in time? He's dipping low. Earthen Wall Totem from Metaphors is stabilizing Sheepy Boy as he recovers through this attack, and Storm stay alive.
Yeah, but Cubsy was able to sneak away and drink to full during that, so Super Frog's still feeling very healthy in this matchup. Sheepy Boy getting low, and normally you expect the composition that Storm brings to out-mana Super Frogs. You just have more raw damage. Your main objective is to out-mana, but if Cubsy is never being shut down on these drinks, I just don't see that really happening with the way these games are being played. Metaphors gets counterspelled. Sheepy Boy getting bursted down. He's trying to deny some of this damage with the Vampiric Embrace, assist with some of his own healing, but the Icy Veins of Wealthy Man kind of getting denied here. There's a good psychic core by Sheepy Boy. Wealthy Man manages to find a sheep onto Maldiva. Is there any CC on Metaphors? Doesn't look like just yet. Full bash secured. Sheepy Boy getting lower. Could be a full Cyclone. Ring of Frost gets dropped there by Wealthy Man. Sheepy Boy trying to survive once again using the dispersion.
Uh-oh.
Gets low. Trinkets out. Still not out of it just yet. Metaphors does have the Spiritling Totem if he can get out of crowd control, but Snuts continues the chain with a beautiful Garrote into full Cyclone. Honestly, Storm is just getting destroyed.
Yep, perfect crowd control. Likely a Spirit Link Totem is needed here. Relying on that Earthen Walls defense to be enough to stay alive, and it looks to be the case. No, now Sheepy Boy Cycloned at low health, and it almost looks like Super Frogs have been playing Rogue Mage together for a decade at this point. They're definitely ready to own the tournament here today. Wealthy Man has stepped up to another level in terms of competitiveness here today, and Snuts is supporting him effectively. Cubsy as well, perfect synergy, good execution. They've isolated Sheepy Boy once again with tons of pressure. Maldiva's trying to take control of the fight, find some counter-aggression with those Chaos Bolts, but Wealthy Man again denies the second one, allowing Snuts space to breathe and push forward and be aggressive. They're establishing the mana lead. They're establishing a cooldown lead. They're establishing basically that they are just a better team at this point in the tournament today. Storm need to crank up the damage, and they need to crank it up now.
Yeah, they definitely do, but Sheepy Boy into a kidney shot. Once again, a 3-on-1 situation. No dispersion. Void Shift has to be used onto Maldiva. One of the last lines of defense, but luckily for Sheepy Boy, he has dispersion and Vampiric Embrace rotating back up, but Cubsy, full mana in this matchup. Storm just doesn't have the damage to actually close out the game. It just feels like a matter of time. Super Frogs, with these consistent setups, eventually they'll be able to take Sheepy Boy down where he doesn't have a cooldown available during one of these beautiful setups. I don't know what Storm has to do, but it's got to be something, and it's got to be something fast.
Yep, here we go. They've stabilized. They've traded for that Glider's Medallion on Blind. Fair trade on Metaphor's part, but now he needs to avoid Polymorph at all costs. He blinks into the Smoke Bomb, tries to avoid the interrupt. Grounding Totem denies it for now. Wind Shear breaks up the chain, but now there's no denial left for Metaphor's. He's Frost Nova, able to get out of it. Now Polymorph is being casted. Who has the stop? Wealthy Man's trying to fake cast an incoming spell lock. He secures the Polymorph. Sheepy Boy doesn't have much. He fades. He runs into the corner to line of sight Wealthy Man, but Wealthy Man is still right next to him. The Polymorphs are not stopping. Cubsy's in position to get Cyclones. It's a 3-on-1. Sheepy Boy cannot do anything in this exchange as Super Frogs close out game two.
I'm no weatherman, but it is nothing but clear skies. The Super Frogs are on a holiday. Tweaks will allow them to at least make it to a game four.
Yeah, in the last two games, we really saw Wealthy Man and Cubsy, how much synergy these two have. What we need to see in this game is how much synergy Metaphors and Sheepy Boy have. Sheepy Boy being a new addition to the roster, is he going to synergize well with Metaphors? They have to get crowd control together, have long CC chains if they actually want to end up closing out the game.
I think in the long term, it's a smart decision to try and bring Rogue Mage onto their roster, but bringing it here maybe for the first time in the tournament, facing down the Super Frogs with Cubsy and Wealthy Man's Mage Druid synergy over multiple years, and of course Snuts, the multi-class passing Master to back them up. I'm not sure if it's going to work out for them. They appear to be attacking Metaphors, and I'm going to take a double check to make sure if he's running that Balance Affinity. That is typically what you see. No, he's actually running Guardian Affinity, so it is unlikely that Metaphors will be taken down in this specific match. I am expecting that Snuts is anticipating a Balance Affinity, and this is why he's going after Metaphors, but he is not going to be able to find a kill due to the Guardian Affinity.
Yeah, well, we've talked about Arcane Mage and how much damage it's able to deal, and potentially what their best strategy is to just try to CC up Sheepy Boy in this game. CC Nesper, have that Mage Druid control, train down Metaphors, and try to find these windows of opportunity. So far, though, Metaphors has been dealing with it quite well. He still has a renewal. His mana isn't doing great. Now gets caught into a Kidney Shot out of form. Frozen Orb gets dropped down by Wealthy Man in the matchup. He also draws an Icy Vein, so committing a lot of offensive damage here, and really all they managed to get was the Barkskin, which isn't that much.
Yeah, I'm curious why they aren't going after the Rogue Nesper. Typically, a Rogue Mage is either you're targeting the Rogue or you're targeting the Mage. Training down the healer is not usually what you do. Maybe you open on the healer or you swap to it if you get the trinket, but this is very atypical for Super Frogs to go strategically. Maybe on hook point, they expect to be able to rush down the healer. Nesper actually makes a swap to Cubsy, trying to pull out an opportunity on his own here. Manages to at least find Barkskin, maybe an opportunity later. Both druids are just being targeted down, and maybe it's the case that in this current meta, the druid is the most vulnerable target before dampening. I don't believe we've even seen a Rogue Mage mirror in this current meta, and this is the first time, especially with peculiar specializations like Arcane Outlaw. So this is definitely a first time here in game number three.
I don't know what Storm's strategy is. Cubsy right now, he's playing Balance Affinity, so it's going to be difficult for Sheepy Boy to actually land Polymorphs. And Sheepy Boy also isn't playing Ring of Frost, so if Cubsy is in that Balance form, the Moonkin form, or Bear form, there's going to be no crowd control chains onto Cubsy, and I think he should be able to heal through this pressure. Potentially, their strategy is to run Cubsy out of mana with the spell steals of Sheepy Boy. Cubsy now sitting a full blind. Do they have any damage onto Wealthy Man? Doesn't seem like the burst is available just yet, and Cubsy's actually going to re-stealth out of that. Look for some mana. Beautiful Polymorph from Wealthy Man. Finally, Sheepy Boy's able to deny some of that drink, but Cubsy basically reset his mana entirely.
It seems like Storm are playing for an ultimate dampening Rogue Mage. Metaphors is not running Cyclone, and Nesper is running Dismantle, so he can avoid damage from the Rogue Snuts. And Storm are definitely known as a dampening team, but I'm not sure if it's necessarily going to work in this case with Rogue Mage. Maybe potential with Sheepy Boy's spell steal into dampening, they can out mana Cubsy. That may be what they're looking for strategically, but they're treading new water on match point, and that is a risk I'm not sure that they are going to be able to take, as Super Frogs have been outperforming them throughout the series.
Yeah, Snuts caught into a stun, taking a little bit of burst damage, but Nesper is the one that is in a little bit more trouble. If we look at mana, I'm curious to see what Cubsy's at this particular point of the game. Bash onto Metaphors. Wealthy Man looking for some crowd control. Unfortunately, isn't able to find it. Cubsy backs him up with a full Cyclone. Nesper now getting low. Dismantle Snuts, avoiding some of that Rogue damage, but Wealthy Man still able to put out a little pressure. Sheepy Boy denies with Polymorph. Nesper now still sitting on his Trinket, as well as his Cloak of Shadows and Evasion. His Cloak of Shadows and Vanish, so he should be able to survive. He has a lot of defensives to rotate through. And both teams right now don't have that great of an offense. There's not a lot of openings. Both of them are going to be looking for windows of opportunity.
Yeah, moving forward, Nesper is now vulnerability. Metaphors has no Gladiator's Medallion. Definitely crowd control opportunities for Super Frogs. They've got big powerhouse cooldowns with Icy Veins and Vendetta. So let's see if the Super Frogs can execute on this and close out the match. They don't manage to snag a Polymorph onto Metaphors. That would have been critical in finding a kill. It got stalled out just long enough for Ironbark to be connected to Nesper and deny a lot of incoming damage. Mana is not looking too good for Metaphors on the side of Storm, which is what I'm imagining is what they were trying to play for. Now Snuts gets stunned up as they've crowd-controlled Cubsy. Metaphors is trying to restabilize his mana pool, whilst Storm is crowd-controlling the enemy team, so giving up a bit of an aggressive position to regenerate mana and get a lead in that regard. Moving toward dampening. Nesper now getting bursted down by the Super Frogs. Has Cloak of Shadows. There's the Dismantle. This is an honor talent for Outlaw Rogues, which can take the weapon away from a melee class and prevent Snuts from dealing damage. Effectively used there to deny a kill.
Yep, Wealthy Man going to be able to survive off the back of that Iron Bark coming in from Cubsy. We're now at dampening. And with the way this matchup's playing out, it's looking like dampening is going to be a requirement to actually close it out. Everyone's kind of sitting on their defensive cooldowns. There hasn't been that much pressure. These Restoration Druid swaps have been the most pressure we have seen so far, but there's been really no commitments. I mean, no one's been in a situation where they don't have Trinket, Barkskin, and Ironbark to deal with one of these swaps, and they've been able to stabilize quite easily.
One strategy an Outlaw Rogue can bring is a pistol shot stun into a sap. We have not seen Nesper employ that crowd control. Now he's on the back foot as Cubsy initiates an attack. Not able to get a Cyclone. Good denial by Nesper, but Snuts gets the follow-up. Metaphor's forced to Trinket. Nesper's still falling behind. Huge damage from Wealthy Man. Now a swap onto Cubsy as Storm tried to pull it together here in potentially the final moments. Nesper holds on by a thread. Dampening is now starting to mount, and looks like Cubsy is just going to be the kill target for Storm. Can they take Cubsy down in Dampening before they run out of mana or before the Super Frogs can set up on them? Smoke Bomb now available, potentially dropped here onto Nesper. No, instead deciding to save it for a later date. Instead, just committing raw pressure to try and bait a cooldown from Nesper, who is not falling for that bait. Nesper substituted in here in game three, looking for a three match comeback. Can they pull it off is the question. They've gotten a couple of close calls, but overall, I think Super Frogs are dominating.
Yep, Sheepy Boy now into a sheep. Nesper still under pressure, looking for a swap here on Cubsy. He gets caught out of form into the pistol stun. Snuts getting dismantled. Nesper really trying to control up the game with this Outlaw Rogue, but the damage just isn't there yet. And Sheepy Boy's been interrupted by Snuts with a nice off kick. Wealthy Man counterspelled, and he's getting spam polymorphed, and he really just can't find the damage. Eventually, I feel like the Arcane Mage with his spell steal spam will be significant enough that they can sort of out-pressure potentially some of the heal over time effects that Cubsy has available. Nesper actually getting swapped to, forced to use the Cloak of Shadows, getting lower in this matchup, and he manages to stay alive, but that was a nice setup coming in from Super Frogs off the back of that Vendetta of Snuts. Metaphors in a Cyclone, Nesper not completely out of it yet, but I think he should be able to survive as long as Metaphor can connect some heals.
Yep, good restabilization by the side of Storm, but Cubsy now still has a significant mana lead in that front, and as Dampening starts ramping up, the damage isn't going to stop. Nesper locked down by Snuts. Wealthy Man dropping a Comet Storm, looking to burn even more mana from Metaphors. Cubsy pulling back, looking to bait interrupts, but getting caught himself in a polymorph. Finally, some mistakes may be made here, but he was on diminishing return, so there's not much to capitalize off the back of it. There's just so much pressure in favor of the Super Frogs. Maledix soaking up a lot of incoming healing on Nesper as he's barely holding on. Cyclone at low health. Cubsy with an MVP Cyclone. Cubsy moves across the map. They blind. They have crowd control on the Trinket. Metaphors denies it. Nesper stays alive for a few seconds. Cubsy goes for follow-up. Can they just crush through this last remaining defense of Storm? Full polymorph secured. Nesper likely to fall. Super Frogs are asserting dominance here in game number three, as they need just a tiny bit more damage to push Nesper over the edge. They don't have it, but once again, Cubsy getting a full Cyclone onto Metaphors. Any amount of damage could just close this fight out. Nesper holds on. The Cyclones don't stop. Flurry connects. Somehow Nesper is still alive. Vanishes out of the fight, forced to defensively blind Snuts. Manages to stay alive, but not able to scrape any sort of offense off of it.
Yeah, dismantle on Snuts, polymorph now secured on Cubsy, but everyone's full HP for Super Frogs. Nesper now into the kidney shot. Do they have the damage to take him down? Comet Storm gets dropped out by Wealthy Man. Full Cyclone now onto Metaphors. Nesper has to hold on for another 13 seconds if he can. Trying to get some counter pressure here onto Wealthy Man. Cubsy denying it with the Iron Bark. Wealthy Man still pushing in, looking for crowd control with the bash on Metaphors. Can Wealthy Man get anything done? Unfortunately not. DR Cyclone now onto Metaphors. Full polymorph secured by Metaphors, or by Wealthy Man onto Metaphors. And now Nesper, I don't think he can survive this one. If he can get out of the stun, he actually has Cloak of Shadows and Faint. Maybe he can kite and survive. Once again, beautiful setup from Super Frogs, but they just cannot seal the deal.
Nesper just refuses to die on match point, but they have to do more than just not die. They need to get pressure for the team. Nesper pushes forward to find the kill, dismantles Snuts to deny some counter aggression, but this was not the Vendetta. As soon as that dismantle fades, Snuts can pull the trigger. Now he's stunned up before the Vendetta. Cubsy's launching Star Surges in. Snuts is looking to close this fight. Metaphors doesn't have a lot of mana to heal through this next Vendetta. It could easily just be goodnight. Cubsy getting sapped there by Nesper. Maybe an opportunity. There's just no damage. Vendetta gets committed. Snuts is looking to close this fight out at 30% dampening. Cubsy Cyclones the Ironbark defense activated by Metaphors, denying his heals. Cyclone again. Cubsy moves across the map to look to close. Bashes up Metaphors, looking for a Cyclone and a Polymorph at the same time, but he gets denied. Double denial. No, the Polymorph does land. Trinket is forced. Nesper on the run once again, but a full blind with no Trinket. How do you survive, Nesper? How do you do it? Dismantle onto Peekaboo. Blind onto Wealthy Man. I'm surprised now just see him ice block it off, but he's not going for it. Nesper holds on for a few more seconds, catches a swift mend. He just refuses to die.
Yeah, Nesper's still low. Metaphors, you have to top him off. Cubsy freezes his HP with a beautiful cyclone. What is Metaphors going to do? Can they extend the chain? We'll have to see Cubsy in position, looking for a cyclone. Full polymorph snuck in there by Wealthy Man. Bit of a misplay there by Metaphors, and now Nesper, I still don't know how he's alive in this situation. They need to get crowd control on Metaphors with Kleptomania from Wealthy Man and save up some burst damage. They just haven't been able to put that together just yet. There's a Kleptomania. Metaphors completely out of mana, and it seems like Super Frogs, with this pressure, they're just mana burning Metaphors at this point. He just doesn't really have much gas left in the tank to keep Metaphors alive. Another beautiful cyclone from Cubsy. Is there anything on Metaphors? Metaphors actually trying to sneak away for a drink. Nesper's going to be tanking a lot of this damage. He's going to be relying on a Vanish play, but if he gets stunned, this is going to be really dangerous.
I mean, at any point, he could fall. Dismantle denies Kidney Shot for a couple of seconds, but there's no mana to use during these seconds. One Swift Mend, maybe that stabilizes. Cloak of Shadows aggressively by Snuts to try and close this match. He's sped up. He's had enough. Die, Nesper. Die, says Snuts. But even still, Nesper refuses to go down, able to escape the smoke bomb, potentially get to safety with his team back at the pillar, but there's nowhere safe. There's nowhere you can go. You've got no mana left. All that's left is to kill, but he's just lower on health. There's nothing left. Nesper should fall here. Surely he's going to fall here at 41% dampening. Iron Bark, innervate. Metaphor's healing is free. Maybe he can catch a couple of big heals on a Nesper. He's afraid to cast. He doesn't want to get counterspell, but he doesn't have enough healing to heal through without casting, and ultimately Nesper will fall on match point. Super Frogs.
Apple feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.